and welcome back to 25 Days of K-Dramas, Day 14. And today we're going to go back again to another very, very old drama, but which has been kind of a rite of passage kind of drama into the K-drama world and has been the first drama that a lot of people watched and then got really into Korean dramas. And that is, I just need to say two words and you'll know which one it is. Almost Paradise. Yeah, I can't sing. But it is Boys Over Flowers or Koppuda Namja or Hana Yori Dango, which was the original Japanese manga which the Japanese drama was based on. And then we had a Korean adaptation of it. And I believe after that there was also a Chinese and a Taiwanese adaptation of this same drama. I mean, it is that iconic. And we have Imino in one of his first main lead roles. And his hair, oh my god, that curly hair. Oh, after watching the drama, I really also wanted to go to Namsan Tower, which I have. The soundtrack for this drama was also super iconic. Everyone recognizes the main songs. And of course, I bought them all. Kim Bom, who was one of my favorites in the drama, was actually in a very recent drama called Kumiho Dion, which I really want to watch, and I will at some point. But yeah, I really like dimples, so yeah, his dimple. I would recommend this drama to people who want a taste of old school K-dramas, but watch it with a grain of salt, because this drama has all of the cringiness, all of the cliches that you would ever think of. They're all in it. I mean, everything from like the trope of the perfect second lead, the male lead, the fighting over it, the makeovers, the cohabitation, amnesia, the random wild card. There is literally everything. The chaebol parents who would like throw money in order to go away from my son. Yeah, there's everything in this one. So go check it out if you're interested in something like that. And come back tomorrow for another recommendation on 25 Days of K-Dramas. See you later. Bye.